Welcome to this expert mini module on CBM Progress Data. In Project Expert, we are developing and testing a program to support teacher expertise in data-based instruction and improve outcomes for upper elementary students with persistent reading challenges. We have three guiding questions for this module. Throughout this module, we will think through content related to progress monitoring, such as why and how we collect these data. Then we'll review some examples of CBM systems. CBM is a type of progress monitoring, so let's begin by reviewing how and why we use progress monitoring. Why do we monitor progress? Because time is of the essence. The Matthew effect is a phenomenon of the rich getting richer and the poor getting poorer. In reading, this describes how students who achieve on grade level grow at rates that outpace their peers who need supplemental support. Our job as educators is to interrupt this cycle and provide strong instruction that helps our students in need grow faster than their peers in order to catch up. We also know that being able to read proficiently by grade 3 is a critical marker for future success. Again, time is of the essence for supporting students in need. We don't have time to wait until the end of the year to see how they performed on state assessments. Instead, we need to monitor their response to our instruction frequently to be sure we're meeting their needs. Knowing that time is a critical resource, progress monitoring allows us to make timely adjustments to our instruction based on student data. Ongoing checks provide frequent opportunities to ask, is the student making progress? Is our instruction meeting their needs? If no to the above, we're then prompted to ask, what can we do differently? Of all the information available to teachers, why is CBM data useful for making instructional decisions? First, CBMs intentionally measure key skills that indicate broader proficiency. For example, oral reading fluency, or ORF, is informed by multiple skills that feed into fluent reading. Performance on CBMs is also sensitive to small changes. It can be challenging to detect and document the progress struggling readers are making. CBMs address this concern by providing a useful snapshot of a student's growth that can detect even small changes from week to week. Because CBMs can detect growth in a short amount of time, we can also detect a lack of growth. Being able to see changes or a lack of change allows teachers to make more informed decisions about their instruction in a timely manner. Teachers can make adjustments now instead of at the end of the chapter, unit, or year. Furthermore, CBMs are appropriate for monitoring progress because of how short they are, how they can be efficiently administered in the same way each time, and in how they measure roughly the same skills at the same difficulty each time, allowing us to directly compare progress over time. Let's take a moment to reflect on your use of CBM. If you need a bit more time, pause the video to think about these questions. Reflection. Think of a student you've worked with who wasn't making the progress you'd have liked. Did you collect CBM data? If so, how did you use that information? If not, what other information helped you? How did you know whether they were making progress or not? Now let's discuss how we collect progress data. The goal of progress monitoring is to use brief skill indicators. Thus, convention is to monitor with only one measure. This measure should closely align with the content of the intervention the student is receiving. You might progress monitor with more than one measure if the student is receiving a multi-component intervention where one measure would not adequately capture progress. In third grade and above, the most commonly used progress monitoring measure is oral reading fluency, ORF. This is because ORF is a strong indicator of general reading proficiency as well as the skills that feed into fluent reading. With ORF, we recommend collecting one data point each week. Each time we administer an ORF probe, we're getting a small snapshot of the student's performance. It's akin to checking a cake with a toothpick or taking someone's temperature. These are both helpful ways of collecting information, but not foolproof on their own. Instead, our confidence in the data is established with multiple probes over time. The more information we have, the more confident we are that these data accurately represent the student's performance. Thus, we want at least 3 data points to make any decision with CBMs. When multiple consecutive data points establish a trend, we can more confidently make a decision. Once you've collected the data, one of our most powerful tools is graphing the data. Graphs allow us to more easily see trends and patterns over time. For more information on reading and interpreting CBM graphs, see our other mini-module dedicated to this topic. Fortunately, many CBM systems contain useful tools, including some that automate the graphing of CBM data. Let's look at a few publishers. Any of these systems are great for using CBM to progress monitor. Please note, this is not an exhaustive list of CBM systems, and we do not endorse any particular program. AIMSWeb's progress monitoring graph is seen here. You can see they show the students' data, as well as a trend line. Various additional information is available, as noted by the symbols at the top. Next is DIBELS. Here you can see data over an entire school year. Data are color-coded based on trends with respect to the goal line. The gray rectangles show the benchmarks for each period of the year. EasyCBM is another option. Here you can see 4 progress monitoring points. The horizontal color-coded lines are percentile ranks for comparison. FastBridge is the last option we'll look at today. Again, they show a goal line as well as a trend line for the data. Let's take a moment to reflect on progress monitoring. If you need a bit more time, pause the video to think about these questions. Reflection: what questions do you still have about progress monitoring with CBM? Make a plan to find the answers. Possible plans: ask a peer, look up a resource, watch a webinar. Let's revisit our guiding questions. What is the purpose of progress monitoring? How do you collect CBM progress data? What are examples of CBM systems? Progress monitoring allows us to make timely adjustments to our instruction based on student data. Most commonly, we use 1-minute oral reading fluency probes with upper elementary readers. FastBridge, EasyCBM, DIBELS 8, and AIMSWeb are examples of CBM systems. Thank you for your time and engagement during this mini training module. Check out our Project Expert YouTube channel for other mini modules and resources to support database decision-making and reading. Don't forget to like and subscribe. For questions about Project Expert, please contact the principal investigator, Dr. Jessica Tost at the University of Texas at Austin. Dr. Tost's email is jrtoste@austin.utexas.edu. Project Expert is supported by a grant from the Institute of Education Sciences, U.S. Department of Education.